time, there was a little ogre named Shrek, who lived with his parents in a bog by a tree. It was a nasty place, but he was happy, because ogres like nasty. On his 7th birthday, his parents sat him down just as all ogre parents had, hundreds of years before. Wherever the little ogre went, crowds would beat him with festive torches and pitchforks and fun things like that. But whenever he tried to join in the fun, his new friends would suddenly realize that they had other things to do. And so the little ogre found a perfectly rented swamp far away from civilization. Whenever an angry mob came to burn at the stake, he knew exactly what to do. Keep your big, bright, beautiful world. I'm happy where I am, all alone. I got all I need, so read the stinking sign. Keep your big, bright, beautiful world. A party of my own, anyway. Doing what I can with a one-man conga line. Big, bright, beautiful world is all teddy bears, unicorns. Take your fluffy fun and shove it where the sun don't shine. I prefer a life like this, it's not all that complicated. Though I'm fated to be lonely and I'm destined to be hated. If you read the books, they say that's why I was created. But I don't care. 'Cause being liked is grossly overrated. Who needs a big, bright, beautiful world? I got my own little patch of the world. It's not a big, bright, beautiful world, but it's mine alone. It's mine.
Excuse me? It smells like butt.
I stay in my swamp and avoid large crowds. Or haven't you read the stories?
You mean like the story that say I'm a big bad wolf?
Who wants to say I'm a wicked witch?
or the ones that say that I'm a wooden boy? What? I'm not a wooden boy.
Thank you. Attention all fairy tale things. Your welcome is officially worn out. I'm going to go see this Farquaad guy and get you all of my land and back from where you came from. Now this can't be right, I'm all turned around. I passed the old lady by the shoe, took a left at the candy house, a right at Chicken Shack.
Ah! Ah! Oh, hello there.
Look, there he is!
Uh-oh, help a donkey out, would ya?
Look, it's
his. Oh, now that's not very nice, it's just a donkey.
Step aside, Ogre, and, let us at him.
Why? What did he do?
He's a talking donkey. A freak of nature. As are you, you unsavory beast.
You're going the right way for a smack bottom you are.
By the order of Lord Farquaad, I'm authorized to rescue both.
Under arrest, eh? This is the part where you run away. And don't come back!
Man, can I just say, that was incredible, the way they were tripping all over themselves just to get away from you. I like that.
That's great. Now why don't you go celebrate your narrow escape with your friends?
But I don't have any friends.
Oh, there's a shocker.
Say, you lost or something?
No, just trying to find the quickest way to Duloc.
Oh, Duloc, I know Duloc. You've got to let me show you the way, because I am like a GPS with fur.
I'll be fine on my own, thanks.
But nobody's fine on their own, not when you look like we do. okay. Hey, didn't you hear what they said? Man, this place is going Stepford. And we gotta join forces, otherwise they're gonna lock me up and I cannot go back in a cage. I don't know if I mentioned it or not, but I did 6 years in solitary for impersonating a piñata.
No!
Listen, little donkey, look at me. What am I?
Really great?
No, I'm an ogre, you know? Grab your torch and pitchforks. Doesn't that bother you?
Nope.
Really?
Really, really.
Oh.
Man, I like you. What's your name?
Shrek.
Well, you know what I like about you, Shrek? You got that whole, I don't care what anyone thinks of me thing. I like that. I respect that, Shrek. You all right?
Good. Goodbye.
You don't understand what it's like to consider a freak. Well, maybe you do, but that's why you gotta stay together. No, no, no. Don't speak, don't speak, don't speak. Just hear me out. I might surprise you. I'll be your friend when others despise you. Don't roll your eyes. Stop with them open. My calendar's open. I'll bring you soup when you feel congested. I'll bail you out when you get arrested. I got your back for what? When things get scary. And I'll shave it. When it gets hairy, don't let me go. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Oh, 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 oh. If you kill a man, I'll hide the body. So what do you say? You're not responding. I think we're bonding. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. different grits, like kibbles and bits, like Yang and Yin, Kanye and Kim, like chips and dip, attached at the hip, but not no lady hit the mind break. I'm gonna be on you like a fat kid, okay? I'm like Cupid and Psyche, like Pop Rocks and Mikey. We'll sit together like that Velcro stuff on the fuzzy side, you get the spiky. Like little kids in pajamas with those funny dudes in the bonito feeties, like donuts and almond goes and donuts. Donuts and diabetes. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Don't let me go. Hold me, hug me, take me, please. Na 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 na. Please don't let me go. I need you. 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 Don't let me go, go, go. Don't let me go.
All right.
Yes, okay.
Just this once, and only because I'm lost, you can come with me.
Man, you will not regret this.
Too late.
Now that's what I'm talking about. Shrek and Donkey, two stalwart friends off on a whirlwind big city adventure.
Thelonious, I am ready. Bring in the cookie.
Oh no, what's happening now? Oh, this is scary. Oh no, oh no, no. Oh no, it's you.
Run, run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me, I'm the gingerbread man. You're the monster. You and the rest of that fairy tale trash poisoning my perfect kingdom.
It's not a kingdom because you're not king.
Oh, but I will be just as soon as I find a princess to marry. And I hear you know of one. Tell me where she is.
Eat me.
No. I've tried to be fair to you and those creatures, but now my patience has come to an end.
Tell of the princess.
From who?
Do you know the Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man.
Yes, I know the Muffin Man who lives on Drury Lane.
Well, I heard it from the Muffin Man.
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man!
He heard it from the Muffin Man.
Can I go now?
You haven't told me where she is.
I can't.
You will.
I won't.
Tell me or I'll.
No!
Then where is the princess?
Okay, I'll tell you. She's a day's walks from here in a dragon.
sounds dangerous.
You want a princess or not?
Go on.
In the highest room in the tallest tower, you'll find a fiery redhead named Princess Fiona.
Princess Fiona. She sounds perfect. Except for that dragon and lava thing. I'll have to find someone else to do that.
Big surprise.
Captain, round up your men and bring the cookie to the swamp.
Swamp? That's the thing that I get?
Thelonious, tell the royal coiffeur I need to get my hair pressed. We are getting a queen!
If you do that one more time!
You see, that's another reason you need me around. Who else is gonna fill you in on all the exciting things you missed out on? You may not know it yet, but you're one lucky over to me.
Punch Buggy! Mutton cart at 3 o'clock.
Oh, Mother, how would that hurt?
You know, Donkey, you're right. That was pretty fun. Want to play again?
No, it's all right. How about we move on to I Spy or I Went on a Picnic, you know, something that isn't going to put me in a body cast.
Oh, would you look at that? It's Lord Farquaad's castle.
Didn't I tell you I'd find it?
It's a bit much, don't you think? Do you think that maybe he's compensating for something?
Oh, forget it, let's go.
Hello, and welcome to the Farquaad Fetch a Princess Festival. The show's about to begin.
Hello?
Ah!
Oh, yeah, someone's going to eat you!
Why me? Ah!
This place is weird. Let's go see this Farquaad guy and get out of here.
Ooh, I want to stop in the gift shop to get a t-shirt.
We're not stopping
yes,
for
we
t-shirts!
Are.
And so
no one from the gutter
People of Tulak, the moment we have all been waiting for, the raffle drawing to determine who will be setting forth to rescue Princess Fiona from the fiery keep of the dragon.
Hello. Roar.
Ah! No! 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 Ah!
Excuse me, are you at Farquaad's?
Maybe. Does the name strike fear in your heart?
No, but the tiny little hat does.
Who let the thing in here?
Look, I'll be out of your silky hair just as soon as you give me my swamp back.
Your swamp?
You know, the place where you dumped all of those fairy tale creatures?
Newsflash, ogre. That oozing mud pit is within the province of Dewlock and therefore under my jurisdiction.
Listen here, you half-pint.
Wait a minute. Oh, this is too perfect.
What is?
You. You're big and hulking and, well, wonderfully expendable. People of Tulak, we have a winner. Congratulations, ogre. You have just won the honor of embarking on a great and noble quest.
But we're already on a quest.
To get Miss Swamp back?
Yes, and you've nearly accomplished it. All you have to do is one more tiny little task.
Little task?
Oh, Walter. The dossier on Her Royal Highness, Princess Fiona. People of Tulak, your queen is on her way.
Well, that is odd.
You got that right. What do you know about rescuing a princess anyway?
Oh, come on, I've read the studies.
Yeah. And I've read the sports page. That don't make me a hockey player.
Oh, come on, Dragon Tower, how hard can it be?
We're gonna find out, I can tell you that. What's it say about the princess?
It says that she likes pina coladas and getting caught in the rain.
Oh, she sounds fun. What else?
It also says that she's been stuck in that tower since she was 7 years old.
Oh my God, that's so sad. All alone since she was 7 years old. 7 years old. 7 years old.
You're weird.
Thank you. settle in, girls. It's story time. There's a princess in a tower. Oh my gosh, that's just like me. Poor Rapunzel needs a haircut, but the witch won't set her free. She passes time by singing like someone else I know. As years go by, she sits and waits. As years go by, uh-oh. A torturous existence. I don't remember this part. She wished that she were dead. Skip ahead, skip ahead. But in the end, Rapunzel finds a millionaire. The prince is good at climbing and braiding golden hair. So I know he'll appear, 'cause there are rules and there are strictures. I believe the storybooks I read by candlelight, my white knight and his steed will look just like these pictures. It won't be long now, I guarantee. Number 23. I know it's today.
Oh, here's a good one. It's a classic. There's a princess in a coma. Glad it's her instead of me. Pretty maiden in a glass box, how I wonder, does she pee? Blah, 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 poison apple, boring, boring, evil queen. Filler, filler, been there, read that, seven shorties on the scene. Skip ahead, skip ahead. But in the end, the princess wakes up with a start. The prince is good at kissing and melting Snow White's heart. So I know he'll appear, and his armor will be binding, as shining as his perfect teeth. And then we hold the pose on one knee, and our prenups will be binding. About time we set a wedding date. Day number 958. No, it's today. He'll show up today. Take a princess, any princess. Take your pick, they're all like me. Not exactly, I'm still waiting. They're out living happily. Ever after, better get here. I want love and sickness flat. And no one needs these middle bits. Oops, did I do that? Cut the villains, cut the vamping, cut this fairy tale, cut the peril and the pitfalls, cut the puppet and the whale, cut the monsters, cut the verses, keep the intro, not the verses, and the waiting, the waiting, the waiting, the waiting, the waiting. So I know he'll appear, otherwise seem a bit bipolar. Now I'm a vandal now as well. Hope you won't mind. I'm a fine, I'm a catch, and a very gifted bowler.
get it, Shrek. Why didn't you just make Farquaad give you your swamp back?
No, there's more to ogres than people think.
Example?
Ogres are like onions.
They stink?
Yeah, no!
They make you cry.
No.
Oh, I know, you leave them out in the sun and they start turning all brown and sprout these little white hairs.
No.
Then what?
Onions have layers, ogres have layers. We both have layers, get it?
Oh, okay. Okay, you both have layers, all right. But you know, not everybody likes onions. Parfaits, everybody likes parfaits. And they have layers.
Ogres are not like parfaits.
Well, I mean, seriously, have you ever met a person and you say, hey, let's go get some parfaits? And they'd be like, hell no, I don't like no parfaits.
Parfaits are delicious.
This is going to end up being the longest day of my life.
Feel that warm breeze?
Aye.
Get up so suddenly.
That's because we're on a bridge.
Oh, okay. And what bridge is this, may I ask?
The bridge to the Dragon's Keep.
Ooh, the bridge to the Dragon's Keep. Wait. So that intense heat I'm feeling coming up under my hooves?
That would be the Lake of Molten Lava.
Lake of Molten Lava?
Oh, talking. Look, whatever you do, just don't look down.
I'm looking down, Shrek, I'm looking down.
Donkey?
Oh God, I'm frozen with terror.
Look at me.
No.
Donkey!
I can't!
Take me
home. No!
Take a step.
Hey, don't let me go. Don't.
I won't let you go. Donkey! Don't.
Oh my God. Oh, Shrek, was that you? Oh man, you gotta warn somebody before you just crack one off. Your mouth is open and everything.
Donkey, that wasn't me. That was Brimstone. If it was me, you'd be dead.
Yeah, right. Brimstone. Don't be talking as the Brimstone. I know what I smell, and it wasn't no Brimstone. It didn't come from no stone, either.
Oh, look. A helmet. Hope this is fireproof. I'll be off.
Wait, you expect me to wait here by myself?
Unless you'd rather come slay the dragon and rescue the princess.
No, waiting's fine, but hurry back. Man, this place is creepy.
You don't know the half of it.
Ah!
Just like you, none of us made it though. For the lucky ones, the rest should incinerate.
something in your eye.
I'm no princess, but he wants me. No great beauty, but he wants me. No one ever, ever, ever wanted me. You're gonna stay, you're gonna stay, you're gonna stay forever.
Well, I wasn't talking about me specifically.
I'm gonna love you forever.
Today. Great, I got one of the snoozers. Hello? Are you Princess Fiona?
Yes. Awaiting a knight so bold as to rescue me.
That's great. Where's the door?
But hold a sponsor, knight. This be our first meeting, and I would just like to know what's the name of my rescuer.
Shrek.
Sir Shrek? I ask that you would take this favor as a token of my gratitude.
Thanks.
You were asking about the door.
Yes, where is it?
There is none.
Then how are we supposed to get down?
Why, the same way you came up.
But the same way? Oh, come on, I just.
Now hold this on, Sir Knight. This be at the first meeting. Shouldn't it be a wonderful and romantic scene?
Crackpot magnets.
This is how the scene must go. You standing there, the light you saw. Then you smile and gaze at me and take my hand on bended knee. Bended knee. Bended knee.
Sorry.
And though we've only met, somehow I always knew it would look like this when dreams come true. Brakes are nice, slow down a bit. Shutting girls are delicate. I'm on for this my whole life long, and now you're doing it all wrong. Down a road with speed awaits, that's what every story states. Riding over rough terrain, past the dragon you have slain. You have slain. You have slain.
It's on my to-do list.
What?
Dragon! Why are you bringing it towards me? Doggy, go!
Are you there, God? It's me, Fiona.
Let's play more running!
Tra-la-la-la-la. Tra-la-la-la-la. In the end, remember all your dreams come true!
Come
to you if you can't believe. heart. A life about to start. I knew this day would come, and you would find your way. At last, my dream comes true. I knew.
Prince Charming.
Well, yeah. I was expecting a knight and a noble steed, not some ogre and his pet.
Well, so much for noble steed.
Well, he's not supposed to be an ogre.
Well, I'm sorry, Princess. I was sent to rescue you by Lord Farquaad.
Then why didn't he come and rescue me?
I don't know. Why don't you ask him when we get there tomorrow?
Tomorrow? It's almost sunset. We need to make camp right now.
Camp? We just rescued you.
Yes, and I found the whole ordeal quite exhausting. Now, let's make camp.
Look, that's unfortunate, because we have to keep going.
I want to make camp right now.
Easy. There's a cave right over there.
Shrek, that is no place for a princess.
No, it's perfect. Good night, then.
Like, you want me to read you a bedtime story?
I said good night.
Okay. She seems nice.
By day one way, by night another. This shall be the norm, until you find true love's first kiss, and then take love's true form.
Okay, and this is what I realized, right? If we can escape a dragon, then we can do anything. I mean, man, I could be a steed, you know? Or I could work the crusade circuit. I could even be one of those horses who pull those wagons full of beer. Oh. I'd have to get some hair extensions on my ankles, but I could do it. Who do you want to be?
I don't.
Yeah, but if you had to, who would you pick?
I wouldn't.
I have a man and a sword at your throat, and he was like, look here, you can't be an ogre anymore. Pick something else. Then who would you pick?
I pick the guy up and toss him into a tree.
Man, you are no fun at all. You know that? Gosh. Is this what it's going to be like when we finish rescuing the princess? Us sitting around our swamp all day doing nothing?
Donkey, there is no we. There is no our. There's just me and my swamp. And the first thing I'm going to do when I do get back is build a 10-foot wall around my land.
You cut me deep, Shrek. You cut me real deep just now. What's your problem anyway? What do you got against the whole world?
Donkey, it's not me that has a problem with the world. It seems to be the whole world that has a problem with me. You saw the princess reacted, that's how it is every time. People take one look at me and it's all, help, big, ugly, stupid ogre. They take one look at me and they judge me. That's why I'm better off alone.
Well, you know what, Shrek? When we first met, I didn't think he was a big, stupid, ugly ogre.
I know, Donkey, I know.
So there's really no one else you'd rather be?
Guess I'd be a hero, with sword and armor clashing, looking semi-dashing, a shield within my grip. or else I'd be a Viking and live a life of daring while smelling like a herring. Upon a Viking ship, I'd sail away, I'd see the world, I'd reach the farthest reaches. I'd feel the wind, I'd taste the salt and sea, and maybe storm some beaches. That's who I'd be. That's who I'd be. Or I could be a poet and write a different story, one that tells of glory and wipes away the lies. Into the skies I'd throw it, the stars would do the telling, the moon would help with spelling, and night would dot the eyes. I'd write a verse, recite a joke, with wit and perfect timing. I'd share my heart, confess the things I yearn, and do it all while rhyming. But we all learn, but we all learn. An ogre always hides, and all his fate is known. An ogre always stays in the dark and all alone. So yes, I'd be a hero, and if my wish was granted, life would be enchanted, or so the stories say. Of course I'd be a hero, and I would scale a tower to save a hothouse flower and carry her away. But standing guard would be a beast, I'd somehow overwhelm it. I'd get the girl, I'd take a breath, and I'd remove my helmet. We'd stand and stare, we'd speak of love, we'd feel the stars ascending. We'd share a kiss, I'd find my destiny, I'd have a hero's ending. A perfect happy ending, that's how it would be. A big, bright, beautiful world, but not for me. And all alone,
all alone in Idaho.
So yes, I'd be a hero, and if my wish was granted, life would be enchanted, or so the stories say. Of course I'd be a hero, and I would scale a tower to save a hothouse
tune.
Hey, give me my flute back.
Morning.
Hey, Princess, by any chance did you eat some of those funny little mushrooms by the stream?
Why, of course not. I'm just happy that today is a new day full of new promise and new beginnings. And I'd like to start by apologizing for the way I behaved yesterday.
You would?
Yes, you guys did rescue me. And to make it up to you, I made each of you a daisy chain.
Oh my god! Oh, I've always wanted a daisy chain. Oh, they're beautiful, Princess. Aren't they beautiful, Shrek?
You'll grow to love them. Now lead the way.
So, Princess, do you often frolic with rats?
And if I do?
I don't know, germ-infested vermin doesn't really seem like a thing.
Well, maybe you shouldn't judge someone before you get to know them. Oh, now, what about my husband-to-be, Lord Farquaad? What's he like?
Let's just say men of Lord Farquaad's stature are short in supply.
Really?
Yeah, but he is, you know, a little intimidating.
Well, he must be.
And yet very good at small talk. Look, we're just saying you might want to lower your expectations a bit.
Yeah, like maybe 3 feet or so.
All right, yuck it up. Nothing's going to ruin today. Not today. Now after a lifetime of misery, things are finally going my way.
A lifetime of misery, eh?
You chuckled?
Did I?
When I said lifetime of misery, you chuckled.
Nope.
You did.
Look, I'm sure life must have been hard in that dragon-guarded tower of
yours. It was.
Although it must have been nice to have a roof over your head and a cozy bed, which is more than what I had when I left home.
You're not actually comparing yourself to my life and what I went through, right?
Look, I'm just saying you don't corner the market on unhappy childhoods.
You know, there are things you don't know about me, you know, about my life and, how rough I had it.
What, you ran out your shampoo a couple times?
I mean about my life.
In that cushy tower of yours?
Cushy? Are you kidding? I had nothing in that tower. Fighting boredom by the hour. Princess lonely, walking circles. I had only bare essentials. Army cot, a hot plate, and a chamber pot. And every morning I would boil it. No choice, I had no toilet. Just a view of devastation. Out one window, isolation. In my bedroom, with very little headroom. 20 years I sat and waited. I'm very dedicated. On the walls, the days were added. Luckily, those walls are padded. So I think I've got you.
I'm just saying, A for effort, that's the play. Sad to see a princess suffer, but I have it rougher.
Like that time a mob with torches burned my birches. See the scorches? You're just whiny. I had a flaming hiney. As I fled, I had to wonder if I were torn asunder. Would Noga go to heaven? Did I mention I was seven? So, I think I got you beat. I think I got you beat. Yeah, 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 yeah. I think I've got you beat. I think I've got you beat.
No warm regards.
No Christmas cards.
And every day
was hell on earth day. My dad and mom sent me away. It was my birthday.
I was sent away on Christmas Eve. Their essential loving kind of hot plate in a chamber pot. Every morning I was toilet. No choice, I had no toilet.
And
just a few of dad's
every day was hell on earth.
In my bedroom, one very little bedroom. 20 years I sat and waited.
My dad and mom. It was my birthday.
I missed my prom.
My dad and mom sent me away. So I think I got you beat. I think I've got you beat. Yeah.
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 Yeah. I think I've got you beat. I think I've got you beat.
Yeah,
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 yeah, yeah. I think I've got you beat. I think I've got you beat.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Whoopsie. That's out in an aisle way, say.
Princess, I always said I'd be king, and now look, the last adorable piece to my master plan. That reminds me, how are the wedding preparations coming?
All in order, my lord. We booked the cathedral and the band.
Although I did wonder if you wanted to invite your father, my lord.
My what?
Your father, my lord.
Do you mean that horrible little man who tried to keep me down my whole life? That mild-tempered monster? That vile grunt who abandoned me in the woods as a child?
Well, he did have his reasons.
Lucky please. My father simply could not accept that I wanted nothing to do with the family business. That lowly, dirty family business. My daddy was a miner, so he wasn't much around. Foraging for diamonds. A life spent underground. Daddy didn't talk much. He barely said hello. He simply muttered, "Hi ho," and off to work he'd go. Daddy was grumpy. My mama was a princess. who left her crown behind. Daddy was her true love, so mama didn't mind. I never knew my mama, but she could have been a queen. She married way before my mind. A life spent underground. Daddy didn't talk much, he barely said hello. He simply muttered, hi-ho. And off to work he'd go. Daddy was grumpy. My mama was the princess who left her crown behind. Daddy was her true love, so mama didn't mind. I never knew my mama, but she could have been a queen. She married way beneath her. Beneath her knee, I mean. Oh, Daddy's bed was lumpy, so mommy couldn't sleep. Daddy built a new one, so tall and so steep. 25 mattresses she slept upon. One night she rolled over, and mama was gone. So Daddy was grumpy. Me and my old man, a tale as old as dirt. A bitter, distant father in a tiny undershirt. Daddy up and left me good as dead. Now he lives in squalor, sleeping 7 to a bed. Oh, you abandoned me in the woods, Daddy, but I crawled up and out. If you could only see me now, I'd invite you to the wedding, but you'd have to be this tall to get in. My bride-to-be is gorgeous, her wedding dress designer. The guest list will be major without a minor.
La 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 la.
Packs of royal lackeys playing violin.
Strings of royal underlings.
Who will not let in? Aha, aha, aha. Tricked out carriage.
Tricked out carriage.
20 stallions.
20 stallions.
With a coachman named
Cole.
Big reception. With a boy band. At the royal DJ by the pool. Yes, I can see my future, and so it shall be done. It's total domination, with some torture just for fun. I will have a wedding, and I will have a queen. And once I get that crown on, you will get the guillotine. And I'll punish you, Daddy, because I'm all grown up, and bigger than you'll ever know. You're gonna pay, Daddy. It's any day, Daddy. I'm off to work. Hi-ho.
Sorry, are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Indeed. Okay. Oh, look, we're here.
Where?
Oh, would you look at that?
What?
It's Duloc.
Congratulations, Princess. Your future awaits.
I guess it does.
So much for that batch of Snuthers I was going to make us.
Snuthers?
They're a traditional Ogre campfire snack. A little bit like s'mores, except instead of chocolate and marshmallows, we use squirrel gizzards and mulch. Mm, they just melt in your mouth.
I think I need to sit down for a minute.
No sitting down. We have to get the princess back to Farquaad.
I might not get another chance to try one of those Snuthers.
You eat one of those, and you may not get a chance to do anything.
Zip it, donkey.
All I'm saying is that maybe Dulac can wait until the morning.
Morning?
I mean, I've spent my whole life without you, love. I really don't see what's one more night.
All right, I'll go get us some dinner.
I'll get the firewood.
I'll go this way.
Maybe we should together.
Yes.
There's something going on around here. I've been watching and the signals are clear. A nervous laugh when she brushes his skin. The sweaty palms, the big dopey grin. With a giggle and a flip of her hair, I smell the pheromones in the air. Making goo eyes over the food. They need my help here in setting the mood. Oh, you don't believe love is blind? Well, I got some friends who think otherwise. And here they are, direct from my imagination.
Three blind mice.
Watch your step, girls.
Three blind mice. See how they ride.
You gotta turn up the heat. You gotta go to the man. You gotta make
a move and don't be afraid.
Reach for a hand, maybe give her a kiss.
She's been waiting for a move to be made.
You got to. But you've got to tell this girl what you really feel deep down. You may not get another chance. Just go on now. Just open your heart and...
Princess.
Oh, he's gonna tell her.
I
can't take this.
I was wondering. I was wondering.
Okay. Spit it out.
Well, are you gonna eat that?
Man, what is wrong with you? You gotta make a move, gotta shift and take it. You gotta buckle down and give it a whirl. Christina said right out of a book with a sunset and a beautiful girl. So you got to.
Afraid of the dark too until wait, no, I'm still afraid of the dark. Okay, hold me.
I have to go.
All right.
Good night.
Good night.
Uh-uh. No, sir. I did not come all this way with you and your body odor. Okay. For you to just let her walk away like that.
Donkey, what are you talking about?
I am an animal. I have instincts. And you two are obviously digging on each other.
Look, Donkey, you're crazy. I'm just bringing her back to Farquaad.
Uh-huh. So you don't have any feelings for her at all?
Look, even if I did, she's a princess, and I'm...
An ogre?
An ogre!
She needs to know.
Donkey, where are you going?
To get some wood before your fire dies. Oh.
Thank you.
picked this flower right over there is where it grew. And I don't really like it, but it made me think of you. Because it's pretty, is what I'm trying to say, is that you're all so pretty, but I like you anyway. So please accept this flower with its petals and the stem, which represent my feelings and tells you how I feel. Where am I going with this? When words fail, what will I do? When words fail, how will she know how I feel? When words fail, will I fail too? Hello, fair princess. Oh, look, the moon is out tonight. You remind me of that moon because it's big and bright. And by big, I don't mean chubby. Obviously, you're not fat, but your personality is biggish, is what I meant by that. Sorry about that fat thing. I'm on the hefty side myself, though I have to blame the gene pool, which reminds me of... What am I doing? When words fail, what will I do? When words fail, how will she know how I feel? When words fail, will I fail too? Do I have a snowball's chance? Are my prospects just too grim? I spent my whole life in the mud. Now I'm crawling out on a limb. If words fail, she'll just take my hand. If words fail, she'll understand. She sees me as no one else has. If words fail, she'll understand. She'll understand.
Princess Fiona! Princess! Oh, okay, look, it's dark up in here. I am playing Princess! Princess!
Oh! Oh, my God!
Serious therapy.
night.
You did?
Yes, every word. Especially who could love a beast so hideous and ugly.
I didn't think that would
well,
matter.
Well, it does! Princess, I brought you a little something.
Is
that
what I think it is? Yes. Fiona, 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 Fiona!
Princess Fiona.
As requested, now about the swamp.
Cleared off as the green. Now out of my way before I change my mind. Princess Fiona, I am Lord Farquaad.
Forgive me, Lord Farquaad, I was just bidding the ogre a short farewell.
Oh, that is so sweet. But there is no need to waste good manners with the ogre. It's not like it has feelings or anything.
You're right, it doesn't.
Princess Fiona, beautiful, fair, flawless Fiona, I would like to ask your hand. In marriage! Will you be the perfect bride for the perfect groom?
Lord Farquaad.
Excellent! I shall start the wedding plans immediately. We shall wed tomorrow.
Tomorrow? Can we wed before sunset?
Too anxious, aren't we? Very well. Captain, ride ahead. Tell them it's your code red. You are very right, my dear Fifi. The sooner the better. We shall wed by sunset.
Oh, God, nothing like a good night's nap, but... Freddy, well, over. Shrek, what are you doing? You are letting her get away.
You two are great pals, aren't you? Why don't you just follow her on the way home? There's only room for one person in this swamp, and that's me. There's no room for anybody else, especially not useless, annoying, pathetic, talking donkeys.
What I thought.
You thought wrong! Build me a wall, make it 10 feet high. See you later, pal! Bye-bye. No one getting in, so don't you even try a 10-foot wall. Gonna build me a wall, gonna disappear. What's the matter, pal? Am I not being clear? Can't you take a hint? Am I getting through at all? Just get out of here! I was told the world would despise me, so I should have known, I should have guessed. I thought these two might be different. Well, now I know, they're just like all the rest. I'm gonna build me a wall, I'm gonna disappear. Hey world, I'll do it your way. You're looking for a monster? It's your lucky day. I'll be what you want. What a fool to think she might love me. I opened my heart and let her walk through. She wanted Prince Charming. I wanted my home back. How lucky both our wishes came true. I'm gonna build a wall, a perfect place to hide. Hey world, stay on your side. The best way to conquer, they say, is to divide. I'm gonna build a wall. Hide in my heart! I'm
gonna build a wall!
Thank you.
all people would recognize a wall when you saw one.
It's supposed to go around, Miss Swamp, not through it.
It is around your swamp, see? That's your half, and this is my half.
My half?
Yes, my half. I did half the rescuing, so I get half
the booty.
Stubborn jackass!
Smelly ogre!
This is my swamp!
There you go again! My, me. Well, guess what? Now it's your turn to just shut up and listen. You are mean to me. You insult me. And you don't appreciate anything I do. You're either pushing me around or pushing me away. You're so wrapped up in your layers, onion boy. You're afraid of your own feelings.
So mean to you, why'd you come back?
Because that's what friends do, Shrek. They forgive each other.
Go away!
There it is again. You did the same thing to Fiona, and all she ever did was like you. Thank you, Fiona. Love you.
Love me? I heard you two talking. She called me ugly. A hideous creature, even.
She wasn't talking about you. She was talking about her... someone else.
Donkey!
No.
Donkey! Right, look, maybe I am just a big, ugly, stupid ogre. Can you forgive me?
Hey, that's what friends are for, right?
Friends?
Friends.
So, what did Fiona say about me?
Why don't you just ask her yourself?
Ask her myself!
Yeah, I mean, you always wanted to be the hero. Well, now's your chance.
Donkey, the wedding, well...
Now, what kind of noble steed would I be if I did not have a backup plan? Follow me.
Possibilities
everywhere. If true love is blind, maybe you won't mind the view.
Awkward.
I know I'm not the handsome prince for whom you've waited. I don't have a fancy castle, and I'm not sophisticated. A princess and an ogre, I admit, is complicated. You've never read a book like this, but fairy tales should really be updated. It's a big, bright, beautiful world. I see it now, I'll let it in. I'll tear down the wall and clear a spot for two to be with you.
Boo! Are we ready, Fiona?
I can't.
Standing here and know my Lord.
perfect hair, radiant and rude, so in love and large to guess. See,
we are ogres, we are scary, we are donkeys, we are hairy, we have bold and brand new stories to be told. We will write them, we will tell them, you will hear them.
Little ogre came to live on his swamp with a beautiful princess.
And his best friend.
And his best friend.
And a gingerbread man!
And a very handsome puppet!
And an elf!
And an ugly duckling!
And a witch!
You're right.
perfect remedy for that.
Donkey, please, I'm begging you.
Sing a song, yes, a travel song, when you gotta go somewhere. 'Cause the fun is getting there. Yeah! Oh, what the heck, I must confess, I love a road trip. Sing a song, hit the trail. Forget the maps, forget the guides. Before you know it, you've made strides with me. And I know all I need all along is a path and a pal and a song. So I'm singing and I'm palling with you. See, makes the time go by faster.
Why me? Why me?
This is nice.
Tell me, what was my crime?
We are strolling.
As chatty as a parrot, more annoying than a mime.
Hey, look, a cat who's wearing boots. That's crazy.
Why me? Why me? A simple answer would be fine.
This is good cardio.
Won't someone please send me a sign?
Hey, look, the sign. You need a pal, avenue straight ahead.
What did I do to deserve this, honestly? This ass of mine is asinine. Why me?
Aw, man, what could be better than this?
Why me?
Sing a song,
why me?
The road,
a simple answer,
is the way
would be fine.
To get around.
Oh, before you know it, please send me round a
with
sign.
Me. What and did I know I all I need to all along is a path and a pal and a song, so
this
I'm singing.
Ass of mine,
and
is
I'm
asinine.
With you.
That'll do, Donkey. That'll do.